Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain hint and miss transform of digital image processing. So before starting, let's understand what is hit or miss transform. In morphology, hit or miss transform is an operation that detects a given pattern in a binary image. So what for hit or miss transform is used? It is an operation that detects, it is used to detect a given pattern in a binary image using structuring element. So here you can see that this is input image and this is structuring element. Input image consists of these black pixels and white pixels, that means these are zeros and these are ones. And structuring element consists of all four black pixels and shape is 2 by 2 like this. This structuring element may contain all ones, all zeros, or blanks, or don't cares, or maybe a combination of ones and zeros. So before starting hit or miss transform, let's understand the meaning of when we call it as hit, when we call it as miss, and when we call it as fit. So this is structuring element. When we overlay this structuring element somewhere at this place, again see, these are all four white pixels, and when we overlay these all four white pixels with exactly all four black pixels, then it is said that it is miss, because not a single black pixel is overlapping with each other. On the other hand, when we overlay these all four black pixels with all four black pixels of input image, again see, there are all four black pixels in the input image, and when we overlay this structuring element like this, then we call it as it is fit. And when we overlay this structuring element somewhere like here, again see, somewhere at this position wherein at least one black pixel is overlapping with one black pixel, then it is said that it is hit. So these are the meaning of miss, hit, and fit. Now, how to proceed? Whenever we have this structuring element, we have to start it with this position, and then we have to slide this mass towards right, or you have to slide this structuring element towards right. After that, again, you have to bring it to this position and again slide it to the right, and so that, and your end position should be like this. So let's understand what is hit and miss transform for. Hit and miss algorithm can be used to thin and skeletonize a shape in a binary image. So it is specifically, hit and miss transform is specifically used for binary image. A binary image means only there is black and white. That means only there are two levels, that is 0 and 1. So what for it is used? As I said earlier, it is used for detecting the pattern. It is used to thin the image. That means suppose you have this image and you want to thin this image, then hit and miss transform is used. Or to skeletonize a shape in a binary image. You can see here, this is B, H, A, these are skeletonized. So this is the objective of hit and miss transform, or you can say that this is the application of hit and miss transform. Now let's understand how to perform hit and miss transform of image. So this is input image. It is shown by these white boxes and these black boxes. On this gray boxes, one is denoted. And this is structuring elements. Let's assume that this one is just a symbol. Otherwise, white indicates one and this gray indicates zero. So just understand that one is not signifying any value out here. It is just a symbol. Okay, so first what you have to do is you have to overlay the structuring element at the first position. At the first position, only one pixel is overlapping and hence it is a hit position. Then you have to shift your structuring element towards right, and then you have to overlay at the next position. At this position, only these three pixels are overlapping. So again, it is a hit position. Then again, you have to shift it towards right like this. And again, it is a hit position. Again, it is a hit position. And if you see this, again, see this position, this is a fit position. This is a fit position because all pixels, all these pixels are white pixels in the input image, and you are overlapping these gray pixels over it. So this is a misposition. Then you have to consider, you have to take your marks, this structuring element on the next level, and then again you have to start overlapping it with the input image. So again this is hit position. Again you shift it towards right, again it is hit position. Now if you shift it here, again see if you shift it here, it is exactly fit position. Now when it is at fit position, this is your fit position and your origin is here, so this is your center pixel, so you have to retain this pixel in the output image. Now what you will do next, again you will shift this structuring element towards right. When you shift it towards right, again you will find only hit positions or miss position but not fit position. So what to do then? Again go to the next position. Where is fit position? So exact next fit position is out here, so that means out here. So at this point, fit position, again this is a central pixel and hence you have to make it one. So you have to retain this pixel in the output image. Then again shift your structuring element towards right, and your next fit position is this. Next fit position is this, so you will retain this pixel. You keep this everywhere. Either here you will find it is miss position, somewhere here you will find, here you will find a hit position, here you will find a hit position, here again you will find a hit position. So where is a fit position? The next fit position is out here, and then here again this is a central pixel, that is your origin, and hence we will retain it. Then next fit position is like this, and again it is a fit position, so you have to retain the central pixel, and this is how you have to perform hit and miss transform. So where are, if this is your original image, if this is original image where the hit and miss transform goes, so here you will find the fit position. So you have retained this pixel, then at this position you found it is fit position, so we have retained this pixel. Then again here you observe that it is this position, it is fit position, so we retain this pixel. Then here it is fit position like this, so we retain this pixel, and again it is here, so again we retain this middle pixel, and that's why our pixels are like this. This is retained, then this is retained, then this is retained, this pixel is retained, this pixel is retained, and this pixel is retained, and your output image is something like this. After operation of hit and miss transform on input image with this particular structuring element. Now remember that if structuring element changes, then your output image will also change. So you can see that this is almost a skeleton of this input image, or you can say that we have just detected a pattern. What kind of pattern is available in this input image? You can see another example. Hit and miss transform is an iterative process. It is not like that we use only one structuring element. We can use multiple structuring elements on the input image to perform hit and miss transform. Hit and miss transform, it is an iterative process. That means first you apply one structuring element, then next, and then next, and then, and go on repeating the process. Process containing repeated steps to thin the skeleton or thin the image by hit and miss method. In each iteration, some different structuring elements are used to identify the edge pixels to be removed. So here we have seen different structuring elements are available. This is input image. Let's take the first structuring element. That means, let's consider this structuring element. So when we overlap this at this position, it is complete miss position. Then shift it towards right, that will be hit position. Where is fit position? Fit position is out here. Here it is fit position. So when we put it here, then you have to retain this gray pixel like this. This is origin. This is origin. Now again, shift at every position. What is the next fit position? Your next fit position of this structuring, for this structuring element, will be this. Next fit position is this. You can see, because this four pixels are exactly similar to this. So this will be a fit position, and at for this fit position, we have retained this pixel, that is this pixel. And then what is next fit position? Next fit position will be this. Actually, you have to shift it at every position, but we will retain the pixel only for fit position. So we have retained this. So next position, so we have retained this pixel. Similarly, what are the other fit positions? This one is your fit position, so we have retained this pixel. And the next fit position was this, so we have retained, again, see, this is a fit position exactly similar to this. So this is fit position, so we have retained this, and so on. After performing all this operation by using first structuring element, then you have to go with second structuring element. Now we'll put second structuring element. So here you can see it is similar. Here it is exactly fit position. If you take this, here it is exactly fit position. So at this fit position, so we have retained this pixel. Then where is again, this is again a fit position, but this is already retained, so we need not to do again. This is also a fit position. So this is fit position, so we have retained this origin, that is this pixel. Then this is again a fit position, so this is again a fit position, so we have retained this pixel. Now let's go for next, that means this. So where it is a fit position, you can see here, this is a fit position for this structuring element. This is a fit position like this. So here, so we retain this pixel. Where else there is a fit position? Here again there is a fit position, but it is already retained by something like this. So it is retained. Then where else? Nowhere. Now next, we'll go with the next. Where it is a fit position, there are multiple fit positions I will show you, but all the pixels are already retained. So where it is a fit position, here it is fit position. Then you can see, yes, this is a fit position. What else? Yes, that's it. So, but these two pixels are already retained, so we need not to do anything or any changes in the output image. So with this iterative method, that means we use this structuring element, this, and then this, and then finally we got this output image, because it is a repetitive process. We have to iterate. It is an iterative process containing repeated steps. Now let's take another example. Very simple. This is input image and this is structuring element. Where is the fit position? So here it is fit position, so this is retained. Then here it is fit position, so this is retained. Then again, yes, here it is fit position, so this is retained. And here it is fit position, so this is retained. You can see here, if this is your input image and these are structuring element, and you can see that this 1, 1, 1, these are rotated at every place. So first this structuring element is applied, then this is applied, then this is applied, and then this is applied. And after application of all four structuring element, you will get this image, that is hit and miss transform. So it was all about hit and miss transform. I hope you understood the concept, as I tried to make it as easy as possible for you people. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.